Oje lo e sun laki
aye kutide
aye sun laki
aye kutide
lori Facebook
aye kutide
aye sun laki
aye kutide
lori YouTube
aye kutide
aye sun laki
aye kutide
o baba de wure
aye kutide
aye sun laki
aye kutide
DJ Badi ye Presido da Rufio,
aí
é só lá. Igoni na Boje, aí é só lá. Olha o patinho da Rifa, aí é só lá. Acho que tinha Rufio, aí é só lá. O Lula ou o Lochelu. Aye sunaki,
aye kutide.
Oje lu e sunaki,
aye kutide.
Aye sunaki,
aye kutide.
Use this opportunity to say a word on the recent genuine concerns and agitations by Nigerians about the excessive use of force and, in some cases, extrajudicial killings and wrongful conduct by means of the Nigerian police force. The disbanding of SARS is only the first step in our commitment to extensive police reform in order to ensure that the primary duty of the police and other law enforcement agencies remains the protection of lives and livelihoods of our people. We will also ensure that all those responsible for misconduct or wrongful acts are brought to justice. We also deeply regret the loss of life of the young man in Oyo State.
I dare to tell this nation today that this is the problem. This constitution can never give us progress. This constitution can never give us peace. This constitution can never give us unity. And unfortunately, most of us in this National Assembly, we don't have the spine to face what we need to give this republic to have peace and progress. What do I mean? This constitution has 68 items. 68. On the exclusive list. This constitution has only 12 on the concurrent list. And those 12 are written so nebulously, so fraudulently, that you know that the intention is to even undermine those concurrent lists. The formal name of this republic is Federal Republic of Nigeria. Unfortunately, we don't run a federalist system in Nigeria. Otherwise, what is so unique about all those things that are in the exclusive list? In this chamber, we try to federalize the police system. In this chamber, we failed. Every crime is local, and the solution to every crime is local. The earlier that senators in Nigeria summon the courage to say, we should not continue to deceive ourselves.
Good evening. Welcome to Mayegun's Diary Political Tonight. I'm sorry that I came in late. It is a complicated business. Just to make sure that we have a detailed conversation, uninterrupted conversation on our program today as a continuation of updates on what is going on in Nigeria. So thank you very much for joining me. And if you are watching this, I will advise that at least finish with us tonight, immediately after this video, go and watch my previous video. It is the continuation. So if you want to keep tab on what has been going on in Nigeria, especially on NSAS in the last 13 days, yes, this is just the latest. You have missed some episodes. So after this broadcast, yeah, please watch them too. Thank you so much, everyone, for your time again. And you are, for many of you who have been following what is going on in Nigeria in the last 48 hours, and most importantly, in the last 24 hours, things don't change. Oh. And the truth is that the worst is about to happen. And why? Because the most dreaded action that people were saying, no matter how provoked that this protest becomes, or no matter how demanding the young people in Nigeria become in their protests for a better and new Nigeria, right? That the government must never be tempted to use the force of arm. But they are using different tactics now. They are using the force of arm. They are killing protesters. They are aiding and mobilizing thugs to attack peaceful protesters. The whole world has seen that the protest in Nigeria, which attracted the whole world to what is going on in Nigeria, the whole of Africa, yeah, is because of how coordinated, orderly, and peaceful the protest in Nigeria has been. The NSAS, NSWAT protest in Nigeria has been, and they remain peaceful, coordinated, violent. Very peaceful. But the government of Nigeria have tried so many methods to try and break the protesters. And as we feared, I told you it's going to happen. Okay. And tonight, I'm going to also give you an idea of what you should look out for in the next few days, as Nigeria will now go full-blown into revolution. Those who are saying this is not revolution, don't mix it together. Don't worry. I told you, I said, don't rush, okay? It is NSAS. I agree with you. But that is your own understanding about it, okay? There is no other agenda than the agenda of that average young man and woman on that street, who is using the opportunity of being able to speak out for the first time, the bottled up frustration, right? The bottled up oppression that he or she was born into. The first time in the history of that country, 60 years, even Oyibo, we not do protest to pursue colonial masters. Do you get that now? No protest. So this is the first time in the history of Nigeria that they are going to have a protest that lasted more than 13 days. Wow. And they don't know how long it's going to go or how far this is going to go. So you see everybody you see on that street, every person you see protesting has a story. And each story is of anger, disappointment, oppression, depression that Nigeria has brought upon them. So you may think it is just about SARS, because in your own naivety, you are trying to deny other feelings, other obvious abuses that other people have suffered. So yeah, don't rush. It is not revolution, Abi. In another few days, you will begin to shout revolution. And that is why you should pay attention to this broadcast tonight. Olawale Jimo, my person, thank you very much for your super sticker as usual. So as I want to say thank you to every one of you who always sort of feel like you should use that dollar sign beside your comment. You know, if you are on YouTube and you see your comment there, that comment box, there is a dollar sign or something like that, maybe dollar, maybe your own currency in your own country. So for those of you who even like deem it fit to use that, I want to tell you that I do appreciate that gesture by no small mean. We are talking about money, so I have to be very grateful for everyone who can actually give out his own penny simply because you just love this guy. So thank you, Olawale Jimo. And to my members, all these per annum, per month, paying members of Mayegun's Diary Political too. They are the fan base. We are building. We are now about, I think we are now up to 58. I have 58 members. How proud do you think I am? So proud of them. Thank you. So I actually watched out the time. I'm like, oh dear. Thank you. So I'll continue to give shout out to every one of you who has contributed to this journey. Saint Alex, oh, Alex, you are back. Thanks, Baba, for that too. Let us fire on quickly. Revolution is here. Many of you who have condemned the hashtag revolution, you are going to begin to use it soon. And I said, this is not going to be most of your making. Many of you went out there expecting your government to at least respect you, put words to action. You wanted to see them do what they say they are going to do. It's as simple as that, yeah? But in the process, you realize that when you are protesting against police brutality, yeah, you are protesting against police brutality. And police are still brutalizing you. Eh? Politicians are sponsoring thugs to attack you to the point that now they want to turn the protest to anarchy so that they can use that excuse to further order their soldiers to start attacking protesters, okay? I told you about 5 days ago, I said, if I knew they were under pressure, they were running out of patience. They said they wanted to have meetings. All the youth said they don't want to have meetings with them. They said they wanted to have dialogue. Now they are saying they want to have dialogue. Dialogue for what? Dialogue is like negotiation. There's no negotiation. These young men and women, this young Nigerian said, listen, this is our demand. We want you to do this and we will tick all the boxes. There is no dialogue. There is no meeting. There is no nothing. Do it. We will leave the street. It's as simple as that. They said, no, no, no. We need to dialogue. You need to leave the street. You need to go. Oh, no, 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 no. That is the only problem. And because they have no plan to really implement anything, they just want to do jamboree here and there. Eh? They will push here and there. They will make it a big thing. At the end of the day, nothing will be done. They just want you to leave the street. And this time around, they will make sure that you never get the opportunity again to come out and ask for anything. You will never get it again. You know what I mean? This thing happens only once in a lifetime, once in a generation. It's going to take another 100 years for this to happen. For those, some of you who don't have an idea of history, and they say those who don't try to study and understand history, they are bound to make the same mistake. You know what I mean now? It's a one-time opportunity. This violence has been introduced by the government, not by the protesters. Let us be very, very clear. Today, something happened which surprised everybody. While the thugs were attacking protesters in Abuja, I'm talking about attacking that they even killed 2 people in Abuja today. Peaceful protesters, oh, people were doing nothing other than just asking government to do something. 2 people were killed by thugs in Abuja. In Edo, in Benin, the whole NSAS protest took a new turn, and it didn't take long before people exposed the lie. You know what? Prison break, oh. My brothers and sisters, prison break for Benin. Prison break, where we say the prison warden, the warders, they didn't even put up any fight. Prison break, where prisoner, awaiting trial, they call them, awaiting trial. Some of them said they have been waiting for trial for 2014. Some said 2017. Oh boy, there were so many things that person we just escape for prison. They do interview. It happened for Benio, but it's in a special place. And I cannot fault them. Okay. So I'm going to take you to Benin today. I'm going to show you Abuja. I'm going to show you that I told you that the soldiers would be on the street only if they could be patient enough and sacrifice someone. But it seemed that probably they heard us. They watched us. And they realized that we told them that probably they are going to sack the IG so that they will make that one as a sacrifice, sacrificial lamb. But it seems that they cannot wait. I said, if they can at least wait till Tuesday or Wednesday before they send soldiers out, they are likely going to sway people's support. Because if they just wake up tomorrow and Buhari just read the press, just read the speech, it doesn't matter. Read the speech, sack the police IG, sack this person, sack that person. Or, just make some action. Some people will begin to say, oh boy, it'd be like say, Baba, don't wake up. It'd be like saying, don't wake up. You know that kind of feeling. Like you, some people, even if it's going to be like a Genji as usual, but they'll still feel like, oh boy, Buhari. And I'm like, Buhari don't say, oh wait, guys, no, relax, oh, wait, too. You mean I say, Buhari don't, you know that kind of a thing. But you mean I say, oh boy, tyrant will always be tyrant, oh, no matter what you do. Chris Adeoye, my Ogasa, thank you very much for your own super sticker, too. Eh? Thank you. Sorosoke. Kuyeke, Sorosoke, really. Ah, oh boy, say, hey, oh boy, Buhari don't the Sorosoke, oh. Hey, you don't sack IG. Oh, wait, but this man, where did they go on? Some people just buy him. Some no go buy him. But at least it could make some sense. But Buhari na collated demented breeding mannequin. So there is all these things, we just imagine now. You see, that's why I have to feel sorry for those who really actually like Buhari. See, guys. Normally, that is why I don't really use harsh words. You know what I mean? Though, except when I'm angry. I don't use harsh words to describe those who support Buhari. I use some beautiful names to describe them. Because it's a choice. They choose to. Even though, like, man, how are you guys surviving it? Like, personally, when you begin to just think about why you supported Buhari, how you made things, you imagine things for him. It's going to make Nigeria peaceful. Nigeria corruption is just going to die. This place is just going to turn to Dubai. All this imagination you made up in your head, 2015, 2019. Guys, honestly speaking, I don't want to be like you. I can't imagine how it feels. The disappointment. You know what I mean? Like every time you want him to act, he's just dead, cold dead. And whenever they finally act on his behalf, it is just like ultra jam pepper scatter. I don't know how you guys really feel. Forget about those who abuse you, who say things and all of that. Like, how do you feel? Like, the disappointment, the letdown. Like, when you look back and you feel like, even now that you are supporting Buhari, Buhari must not go. Buhari will finish his tenure. Like, ask yourself, like, there are some things you want him to do. Even if you don't support violence, right? Okay, fine. Let's agree that not all Buhari supporters support, they want violence, okay? Let us be rational now. Let's think rationally, okay? Let's say you like Buhari and you have your reason, okay? In time like this, how do you feel? Personally, what is your own expectation of a president of a country? The type of Buhari, is this the type of Buhari you want? A cold, dumb, sealed lips, breathing, lifeless mannequin. Like, okay, forget. I want to be nice now. Let me ask you nicely. As a Buhari supporter, at least you have your own expectation. The president will come out and address the country, calm the nerves, address the people, at least make him respond to questions, sack some people, begin to take some actions that, at least, won't you expect that? Won't you expect that? Let's be realistic. Maybe not. I may be overrating you. We know the thinking faculties of the Buhari Dins and the Buhari Didinis. The Buhari Denotus, the Buhari Dijatus, the Ungoziaris, the Unnekaaris, the obedient fools, the sophisticated morons, and the humbled slaves, even those who are the premium Buhari Dins and Buhari Didinis abroad. I'm talking about the premium Buhari Dins and Buhari Didinis, their uncles and their aunties abroad, the Mumu Madus, the Bele lecturers, the Mumu lecturers. They say to be a Buhari supporter, you don't need your sense. What you want they can do when they have already drafted how you go the reason for you. It's so difficult. You will see educated people. They will be imagining things for Buhari. If Buhari reacted, if Buhari should just react last song, hey, these people are trying, you are imagining nonsense. There is no Buhari. Every Buhari you have in your head in 2015 to 2019 and to now, they are just imaginary Buhari the one that will bring a dollar to how much? Bring dollar down to $1 to 1 naira. Abi, eh? It will give you 24 hours electricity, 24/7 electricity. The one that will stop Boko Haram in 3 months. Abi, is that not the one that you told yourself? The one that will bring a liter of petroleum to 14 naira per liter? Or is it not the one that will build refineries? Eh? Is it not the one that will be paying the jobless youth in Nigeria for 5,000 naira? That imaginary Buhari you have in your head, the one that will be paying you unemployment allowance. Have you forgot? That the one that will create 3 million jobs for you. All those imaginary Buhari in your head. You are, even when they are burning down the country, you are still imagining that Buhari in your head. If Buhari, you know Buhari is a soldier. They know that Buhari, hey, Buhari is just imaginary Buhari. Buhari came to kill. Buhari came to steal, to loot, to destroy, to kill, and to divide Nigeria. It's a very simple mission, and he has never changed from it. They have been preparing for a day like this, whereby some people will think, say, they get some craze for head and try to challenge Boko Haram. So because of that, they gave a chief of army staff to Buratai. He didn't make a Buratai chief of army staff because he wanted to protect the north. He's not protected now. Are we not having the young people from Makurdi, young people from Kano, young people from Yola, young people from Kaduna, young people from Yobe, young people from Bauchi, from Niger, and so on and so forth, standing up today and saying, secure north? Buratai is the chief of army staff. Oh. Those in charge of security in Nigeria, 90% of them are from a particular region, same region, that is overrun now by bandits, by kidnappers, by Boko Haram, by ISWAP, by Fulani terrorists, by so many, many things, Baba. No joke. So he didn't appoint them to protect the north. He appointed them to protect the regime. Now that Buhari is no more, now that Buhari is a vegetable, what do you expect? The cabal are running mad. Many people are taking many decisions at the same time. There is no president. There is no leader. There's nobody to coordinate. No one to stand up and say, please don't burn down my country. That is what president would do. Don't you think? Don't you think that's what a president would do? Don't burn down my country. Even if the whole country wants him out, he will stand up and say, please, we are making, you know, it is not to start sending his special advisor on, unfortunately, on sad news, burial arrangements, and condolences matters. Fake Pastor Ruga, Ikene Shatabandu. Eh? They also call him Ikoyi Aristotle. I'm talking about fake Pastor Oshubade, the one that came out to apologize. Eh? We are very sorry that we came late. We didn't, you know what I mean? Come on, guys. Come on. Give me a break. Nigeria is going to witness revolution. It is happening. The government is going to escalate it. This protest is peaceful. Their demands are clear enough. But because there is no goodwill or political will to do it, right? They decided to turn it into what it is now. A lot they happen. They break jail for Benin. Jail for Benin. People will not go all gone, will not go anything. And you know, say now for Benin, from Edo, Oshiomole come from. And these are the people that know that when people finish with Buhari, they are going to come to Nyamo, where he stole money to build himself a palatia, you know, King Solomon Estate. So, this one that people break for prison, peaceful protesters are on Benin or Expressway. They are not at White House, where prison day. All of a sudden, prisoners break. Oh boy, we have the video how they help them to break out. Oh. Now the warders help them break out from Benin prison. Oh. It is a plot. Oh. It is a game. And it is part of effort. To what? To Oh dear. It is an effort to discredit the peaceful protest. So I'm going to show you the video of how they helped the people. They said they are waiting trial inside White House for Benin, now prison yard, how they escaped. I will show you. I'm going to take you to everywhere as usual, all right? We're just going to go everywhere. And to every one of you who is currently on, remember, you can subscribe under that under this video. You should do that if you haven't, so that you won't really miss anything. So all the games, even for Kogi, Yaya Bello has unleashed his ta-ta-ta political thugs. You know, Yaya Bello is currently under visa ban from this America visa ban. Many, many of them are still going to end on that list. Many Nigerian politicians, many Nigerian police officers, many Nigerian military officers, commanders, and every one of them who will hear that, even some media houses are going to be banned. Personalities are going to be banned. Okay, those who support violence against peaceful protesters in Nigeria, they will end up having to stay in Nigeria, okay, and live there. So people in Abuja, they kill people, two people in Abuja today. It's so sad and unfortunate, okay? But I'm going to take you to, let us start from Abuja. I said the policemen or their soldiers are going to be on the streets from today. We were expecting them last night, but they have been moved around now. As I'm talking to you right now, they are moving soldiers across the country now, trying to locate the hotspot state. They call them the hotspot state, the state whereby if anything happens there, the whole world will know. So they will use about 2-3 days to try to crush the protest. Today in Lagos, the protesters took over the Lagos International Airport. Okay, the Abuja protesters have been very resilient as well. They said they are going to go to Aso Rock and they will take over National Assembly. They are going to take over the Supreme Court. They are going to take over all the public offices, including Aso Rock, where Buhari Day. Tomorrow is the big day. It's called the Big Tuesday. Tomorrow is actually the big day given to the government to ensure that they end the SARS and start showing the effort to stop SARS and other reforms. So now it has become big. And from Abuja today, let's start from there. This is what happened. Right. That is those are the soldiers beating up protesters in Abuja today. Okay. And it didn't end there. Okada riders took over Abuja and they are now called the pro-SARS protesters. They were hanged. Journalists are not spared. There are some videos, properties, cars, over 200 cars were set ablaze in Abuja today. Cars of some of the protesters, they were set ablaze in Abuja today. The policemen in Abuja joined them. They protected the thugs. They protected the armed thugs who were shouting, "Allah Akbar, Allah Akbar." See, that is not targeted at your own religion. You will listen to some of the videos. They were those sponsored by government. And to start with, listen to this lady. She is a journalist covering the protest, right?
Like, what the hell? Haba, media person said they beat media person. Wait, hold on. Is this police or normal people?
Mobile
police.
They attacked this girl on some point. Hit her.
They collected her phone.
They stole her phone.
Sahi guys.
They stole her phone from her.
That's
that.
Very well.
Let's go back.
That was in Abuja today. Okay. So, meanwhile, how the violence started, it was early this morning. It actually started from last night in Abuja when they started setting the cars of peaceful protesters ablaze in Abuja. Thugs covered by the government in Abuja. So take a look at this video from last night in Abuja.